No one would have believed in the last years of the 19th century that human affairs were being watched from the timeless worlds of space. No one could have dreamed we were being scrutinized as someone with a microscope studies creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water. Few men even considered the possibility of life on other planets. And yet, across the gulf of space, minds immeasurably superior to ours regarded this Earth with envious eyes. And slowly and surely, they drew their plans against us.
Good morning, sir.
Gentlemen, we are at war. Yesterday morning, a bizarre transport landed at Horsell Common near Woking. It contained what is now believed to be an advance of an invading army, for without provocation, its occupants attacked civilian and military targets. We have with us a journalist who was an eyewitness. Hopefully, he can enlighten us as to the origin and intentions of these aggressors.
At midnight on the 12th of August, a huge mass of luminous gas erupted from Mars and sped towards Earth. Across 200 million miles of void came the first of the missiles that were to bring so much calamity to Earth. Ogilvy, the astronomer, assured me we were in no danger. He was convinced there could be no living thing on that remote, forbidding planet. And that's how it was for the next 10 nights. A flare spurting out from Mars. A beautiful, but somehow disturbing sight. Then came the night the first missile approached Earth. It was thought to be an ordinary falling star. But next day there was a huge crater in the middle of the common, and Ogilvy came to examine what lay there. A cylinder, 30 yards across, glowing hot, and with faint sounds of movement coming from within. Suddenly the top began moving, rotating, unscrewing, and Ogilvy feared there was a man inside trying to escape. He rushed to the cylinder, but the intense heat stopped him before he could burn himself on the metal. A crowd gathered on the common, hypnotized by the unscrewing of the cylinder. Suddenly, the lid fell off. A huge, rounded bulk, larger than a bear, rose up slowly. Its lipless mouth quivered and slavered, and snake-like tentacles writhed as the clumsy body heaved and pulsated. Ogilvy and a few young men crept closer to the pit. A tall funnel rose. Then a ray of heat leapt from man to man, and there was a bright glare as each was instantly turned to fire. The Martians continued hammering and stirring, sleepless, indefatigable, at work upon the machines they were making. People clawed their way off the common, and I ran too. I felt I was being toyed with, that when I was on the very verge of safety, this mysterious death would leap after me and strike me down. That evening, a company of soldiers came through and deployed along the edge of the common to form a cordon. Quickly, one after the other, four of the fighting machines appeared. Monstrous tripods, higher than the tallest steeple. Walking engines of glittering metal, sounding of guns from the column grew louder. There was a heavy explosion. The ground heaved and gusts of smoke erupted into the air. And I realized that by a miracle, I had escaped.
The conflict spread across the area with very high casualties. Mercifully, our artillery managed to finally destroy the invaders. Little is known about these Martians, except that they're resolved upon conquest, and their technology is far more deadly than ours. Observations of the other incoming missiles imply that they have changed course, perhaps in light of our victory, to land in Scotland. All of our forces are being mustered to face them. Our chief scientists and engineers are already working on technologies which may aid us. We must face and destroy this Martian threat. For if we fall, the rest of the world must surely follow. Gentlemen, good luck. The command post relays messages back to the war room. No further advance or construction can be coordinated in the vicinity until a command post has been built. Vehicles brought to a repair workshop can be refitted and repaired back to full operational status. The vehicle factories construct our land-based military equipment, including the transportation for most of our specialists. The training centers are where our specialists learn their skills and techniques. The shipyards manufacture all of our naval forces. The steel refinery processes iron to be used by our facilities. The pits supply the coal to power our production plants. Imported oil is refined into fuel for our vehicles. The armored lorry is an agile and fast frontline vehicle. Its light armor cladding and a single turreted gun protects its crew of four. A six-cylinder engine supplies it with enough power to provide quick support and excellent reconnaissance abilities. Sappers, our highly skilled and versatile military engineers, can now operate more efficiently with these well-equipped and lightly armored lorries. The sappers are expertly trained and regularly updated on enemy technologies. Our Navy is the most powerful military force we have. Our ironclads can bring heavy firepower close to the land and prove very effective at bombarding enemy positions. Construction workers travel in an armored vehicle, carrying the tools and expertise to manufacture our facilities. Our defenses are designed to inhibit and hopefully halt the enemy's advance. The medium gun post has only average firepower and weak armor, but can be rapidly installed in defensive positions. New research has been initiated. Vehicle moving, sir. Destination confirmed. Orders have been sent, sir. Vehicle moving, sir. Destination confirmed. Orders have been sent, sir. Vehicle repositioning. Vehicle moving, sir. Thank you. Sir, the observatories report another Martian cylinder has just entered the Earth's atmosphere. Sir, the observatories report another Martian cylinder has just entered the Earth's atmosphere. Vehicle has completed its journey. Sir, the observatories report another Martian cylinder has just entered the Earth's atmosphere. Sir, the observatories report another Martian cylinder has just entered the Earth's atmosphere. Vehicle has arrived, sir. Vehicle has arrived, sir.
Awaiting orders, sir.
Sir, the observatories report another Martian cylinder has just entered the Earth's atmosphere. Sir, the observatories report another Martian cylinder has just entered the Earth's atmosphere. Sir, the observatories report another Martian cylinder has just entered the Earth's atmosphere. Sir, the observatories report another Martian cylinder has just entered the Earth's atmosphere. Vehicle has arrived, sir. Vehicle has arrived, sir.
Yes, sir? Awaiting orders, sir.
Destination confirmed. Vehicle has arrived, sir. Vehicle repositioning. The current research project is finished. Design orders have been sent for the new project.
Yes, sir?
Vehicle has arrived, sir. Vehicle moving, sir. Destination confirmed. Vehicle repositioning. Our forces are in position, sir. Ready to start the offensive.
Sir. Orders received. Into position. We are under fire, sir. Moving to attack. Battery under attack, sir. Battery under attack. Moving into position. We are under fire, sir. Martian unit destroyed. Moving to attack, sir. Attack!
Message from the front, sir. The Martian-held area has been taken. Vehicle moving, sir.
Sir?
A new vehicle is ready for deployment. Destination confirmed. Vehicle has completed its journey. Battery formed and ready for orders, sir. Construction of a new facility has been completed. Orders have been sent, sir. Vehicle repositioning. Vehicle has arrived, sir.
Awaiting orders, sir.
Vehicle has arrived, sir. Construction of a new facility has been completed. A new battery is ready for deployment. Construction of a new facility has been completed. Vehicle moving, sir. Facility completed. Vehicle has completed its journey. Research is now completed, sir. New research suggestions have been put forward, sir. These are items to bolster the performance and protection of our vehicle. New research has been initiated. A new vehicle is ready for deployment. Construction of a new facility has been completed. Destination confirmed. Battery formed and ready for orders, sir. Facility completed. Orders have been sent, Sykes. Construction of a new facility has been completed. Vehicle has arrived, sir.
Yes, sir? Awaiting orders, sir.
A new vehicle is ready for deployment. Vehicle repositioning. The current research project is finished. Our engineers have new proposals for research. Heavy gun emplacements are well-fortified naval guns. Their long construction time means they are best used for permanent defenses. Design orders have been sent for the new project. A new vehicle is ready for deployment. Vehicle moving, sir. Destination confirmed. Orders have been sent, sir. Vehicle repositioning. Facility completed. Vehicle has arrived, sir. Vehicle has arrived, sir. Construction of a new facility has been completed. Vehicle has completed its journey. Vehicle moving, sir. Vehicle has arrived, sir. A new battery is ready for deployment. Destination confirmed. Orders have been sent, sir.
Awaiting orders, sir.
Vehicle has arrived, sir. Facility completed. Construction of a new facility has been completed. Facility completed. Construction of a new facility has been completed. A new vehicle is ready for deployment. Battery formed and ready for orders, sir. Vehicle repositioning. Vehicle moving, sir. Destination confirmed. Vehicle has arrived, sir. Our forces are ready to attack the enemy, sir.
Battery ready, sir. Moving into position.
Our attack was forced back by the Martians, sir. Construction of a new facility has been completed. Research is now completed, sir.